Luke Herzog, Pacific Grove, California.
For a week, the mushroom clouds left red dots on the astronaut's retinas, bloody phantoms dancing in his vision, haunting him. Closing his lids offered no respite from the torment. It had been 4 days since the bombing stopped, but the fires raged on. Abrams knew it wasn't healthy, taking every opportunity to glance at the destruction below, but he couldn't look away. He was determined to bear witness to man's darkest hours. It was the least he could do, for the guilt was all-consuming. Floating above, watching Armageddon from the safety of their little palace in the sky, Abrams felt his stomach twist. He was no less fascinated by his colleagues, 230 miles above the worst-case scenario. Tofsky had retreated into her calculations, murmuring about fallout and wind patterns. Discarded pages spiraled around her now, as if she was the star in her own solar system. Even Dixon's incessant toothy grin had long since been supplanted by a forlorn smile and furrowed brow. They passed over the half of the planet cloaked in shadow. The fires were more distinct against the black backdrop, flickering like torch bugs on a warm summer night. Abrams was stirred by the sound of conversation, an almost alien concept as the hours passed, usually reserved for discussion of raw data and bleak hypotheticals. The buzz of consoles and the perpetual scratch of pencil lead had become white noise during their dark vigil for the human race. "You spelled apocalypse wrong, darling," chided Dixon. The towering Texan hovered parallel to the engineer, face to face, but upside down. His goatee and shaved head made him look right side up. Tofsky's eyes flickered, then she continued her scribbling. "So I did. What's it to you?" He shrugged, smiling weakly. "Ah, ain't the end of the world."